Hello, everyone. It's Caroline with Microsoft Teams Engineering here with another episode of Coffee in the Cloud. The Work Trends Index report has been released, and it's got important information for those of us in the adoption space and for IT professionals around the world. It's important to understand the depth of the research that we do to put this information together and take advantage of it. There's many trends that you can review in the Work Trends Index report, and you can see it at the link shown below. But I just really want to hop into the first one, which is about culture. 62% of frontline workers say that leadership does not prioritize building culture. I want you to think about that for a second. 62% of employees who have these critical frontline worker jobs feel like their leadership doesn't focus on culture. I don't think that's great. I think that's kind of bad. And here's the thing. If you want to differentiate yourself as an adoption specialist, as an IT professional, as a business leader, the culture of the teams that you drive or participate in is essential to your success. People need to feel like they work in a workplace that respects them, that listens to them, is flexible, but also clear about expectations and policies. So here are three steps that you can take today to improve the culture in your organization. Number one, transparency. Use Teams or Yammer to drive communities where people can ask questions on key topics. Maybe you should consider having a community about hybrid work or workplace practices with regard to being inside an organization or at a facility. Make sure that people can help each other. It's never possible for your HR team or your leadership support team to answer all the questions themselves. It's good to facilitate a situation where employees can help each other. And Yammer is perfect for that with communities in larger organizations, and teams, of course, can do that inside of a smaller one. Second, be clear about your policies. Confusion creates chaos. Use SharePoint Online to have a news feed of core policies. Your internet can be transformed by Viva Connections. Now is the time to make sure that everyone in your organization has access to the same information. Are you in a very small business or smaller organization, maybe only 100 people? You can still use SharePoint as part of your Microsoft subscription. And it is a fantastic place to even do things like allowing people to put in time off requests, sharing vacation schedules, sharing customer feedback. No matter how large or small your organization, SharePoint can help you share priority content, and Viva Connections will bring that directly into Teams. Number three, honor employee feedback. If you don't have a way of getting feedback directly from your employees now is the time to start. There are many third-party applications that build right inside of Teams for this, or you can use Microsoft Forms and design some questions, allowing people to share insights about the collaboration experience, your hybrid work policies, and more. But here's the thing. If you're going to get feedback from people, you owe it to them to tell them what you're doing with that feedback. Did you review it? Use feedback as an opportunity to be able to share commonly asked questions and the answers at maybe a town hall event, which of course you can do with Microsoft Teams. These are just a few of the ways that you can lean in to transform the culture of your organization. You're not a leader, you say? The organization's culture isn't up to you? I disagree. Each of us plays a part in creating the culture of the organizations we're a part of. Even if you just do some of these things with your own peers or with the teams you're a part of, sharing information more openly, allowing for feedback, answering people's questions, you will improve the culture of the organization as a whole. So that's just one of the insights from the Work Trends Index report, and we'll talk about more over time. Go and check it out and give me your feedback here in the comments or in our Driving Adoption blog. Always happy to hear from you. Your feedback is important.